Nick!
Mr. Carroll.
I'm back from my mini retirement.
Mini retirement? Where did you go?
I took a mini retirement vacation to Sorrento, Italy, Paris, France, and London, England.
Wow.
Yep. We were gone for 25 days. This has been a long time coming and something my family and I had wanted to do for quite a while. Mm-hmm. They would say it was something I've wanted to do for quite a while, I think. Yeah, and I drug them along, not begrudgingly. They were willing to go.
Yep.
But it was amazing. We had a really great 25-day kind of break from the norm. Mm. And it honestly felt like we were retired for a while.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's awesome. And it's interesting that you say break from the norm, because I think when people think about retirement, the normal is 65 or later.
Yes.
Right? But if you're in your 40s, okay, I made sure you said it.
Yeah.
But you were able to take almost a month vacation, right?
Yeah,
mini retirement. So today's episode is about really discovering what is your retirementality. And I'd love for you to share a little bit more about what retirementality means to you.
Yeah. Well, I don't remember if I heard this or I saw someone smash it together or I had smashed it together, but this whole idea of retirement and mentality, and that some people's retire mentality is, oh, I'm going to work, like you said, till I'm 65, mm-hmm. and then I'm going to get Social Security, and then, or what we call so-so security. So you are going to go to 65, get Social Security, and then, you know, sail off into the sunset with your beloved and whatever. Yet, there's a lot of people who, you know, I have a good friend who passed away like a month before his retirement mm-hmm. date. Had a massive heart attack on the steps of his administration building and never got to enjoy retirement.
Yeah.
And when that happened, a number of members of my family and I had this discussion about what do we want our lives to be about? Mm. And can we enjoy the time that we have right now on this earth without working ourselves to the bone and, you know, keeling over early?
Yeah.
So for me, my retirementality goes back to when I read The 4-Hour Workweek by Tim Ferriss. And in the book, have we done a book review on that one?
No, we need to.
We need to. Yeah. We definitely need to. In that book, Tim Ferriss recommends taking mini retirements. And I was always really intrigued by what a mini retirement was and how long it was. And could you extend those stays over lengthy periods of time, weeks, if not months, right? And so we started looking at how long could we actually stay away. Mm. Now, my kids are 11, 14, and 16. And you almost knew that better than me. And so one of the things we had to think about was, could they survive for that long without, you know, being with their friends or having access to certain tech and stuff like that, right? But for me, retirementality, mini retirements done often.
Yeah, that's great.
Yeah.
Yeah, I think, you know, for me, my retirementality has definitely shifted being in the financial industry, looking at, you know, when the traditional age is 65 or up.
Yeah.
But then also seeing that people, especially with today's financial situation, like people are really struggling with their finances and making sure that they have enough.
Yeah.
So the thought of retiring in the traditional notion where there's no extra income coming in, like no earned income, can be very scary because it's like, how do I make sure that my money lasts?
Right.
And then just also looking at my grandparents, two of them passed away, but two of them are in their 80s. One of them is about to turn 90. Just looking at the energy level that they have and their ability to travel. Like my grandma, when my cousin was graduating from high school, being in LA, we had to drive up to the Bay Area because she couldn't hop on a plane.
Oh, wow.
So just the thought of like, well, if I want to go to Sorrento or if I want to go somewhere overseas, like I need to make sure I'm physically fit.
Totally.
So why wait? And how can I start having these mini retirements?
Yeah.
You know, on a quarterly basis, yearly basis, whatever the case is.
Totally.
Yeah.
Totally. And I can relate to that. There were, we saw many retirees on our trip. Where we stayed in Sorrento was up on a hill. So if somebody's not ambulatory, right, they can't walk up the hill, they wouldn't have been able to stay where we stayed.
Sure.
They wouldn't have been able to enjoy some of the things we did.
Yeah.
So it really is, to a certain extent, kind of a young person's, like, it's a vacation that a young person should take.
Yeah.
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 So anyway, very interesting.
Yeah.
So our question for you is, around your retirementality, and if you've thought about that, and keep in mind, it doesn't matter if you're in your teens or your 20s or your 30s, 40s, 50s, or 60s. At some level, you should be thinking about what does life look like at the end of my working career, the end? Or are you someone who's going to work forever? I know people who say, no, I'll keep working until I'm 75 or 80. And we maintain that this is an interesting question you posed earlier. So if retirement was not a concept, how would it change your life or your plan or what have you?
Yeah, it's a good question. It's a great question.
Yeah.
Yeah, if retirement was not a concept, meaning people needed to work until they died.
Right.
So there was no escape from work.
Yes.
Because retirement isn't a destination. Then, at least for me, I would really be focused on spending my time and energy and resources on things that I absolutely love doing.
Yeah.
You know, if retirement is not an option, then I'm going to do what really brings joy to me.
Yeah.
And is also going to have the most impact to other people.
Yes.
And especially, I think with, you can probably attest to this, but when you were away for 25 days, even though you're away, it probably allowed you to be connected and grounded to yourself in a much different way.
Yes.
That when you came back, you were now actually able to pursue the goals and projects that we have with much more velocity, passion, vigor.
Totally.
Right.
Way more focus and clarity too about what needed to happen. Mm. And I found that in the midst of my mini retirement, I was not as enamored with checking email or being on my laptop. Whereas when I'm home and I'm working, like that's the in and out, the day to day thing that you do, right?
Yep.
I kind of compare that to my father who retired not too long ago, and he doesn't care. He has no purpose in checking email.
Yeah.
Right. That's not important to him. He reads articles and he sends me articles on the regular.
Yeah.
And then the majority of the time he's like sifting through photos and resorting them, putting them in proper folders, building videos that he wants to share with people that are just like, you know, memories and yep. nostalgia and stuff like that.
That's awesome.
So I think our focus changes when we're not focused on work all the time. We also begin to focus on other things that are probably more important.
Yeah.
Candidly. Mm. The way to do this, and some people will say, how on earth did you make this happen? And I will share with you that we'll go through a little bit of this in a future episode. And we've probably covered it in past episodes around passive income and, you know, playing good defense as well as good offense, those kinds of things. The way that I would describe how we did this is in our family, we have, you know, if our income is here, our expenses are always here. And this gap between income and expenses is what I call the L factor, the life factor. And the life factor over a period of time allows you to do certain things. So by the numbers, if you assume that, you know, a family makes $5,000 a month and they spend $3,000, that extra $2,000 a month is the life factor that over the course of a year, that's $24,000 that can go somewhere. And for us, there's a number of strategies that we use also covered in other episodes, which will be linked to in the description. But just know that by playing really good offense and really good defense, we get to go out and have this kind of fun. And you could too. Anyone can.
Yes. Agreed.
Yes, agreed. Very much so. So our challenge is what?
So our challenge is to really start determining what your retirementality is. Is there a specific age that you are intending on retiring? Is there a retirementality that you're going to be taking on similar to Adam's where you're going to be able to take a 25-day vacation, you know, with your family? So the challenge is to really start to be in the inquiry of what retirementality means to you, and definitely drop in the comments, you know, what it means to you, and really be able to share with the community of explorers here at Mastery of Money.
Yeah, and if you're questioning, like, how would I even make this happen, put that in the comments down below, and we will respond to you in due time as well about how we might help you do that. So until next time, go take some time off. See ya.